SpaceX's huge Starship rocket for eventual trips to the Moon and Mars could go orbital for the first time in just a few weeks from now, if all goes according to Elon Musk's plan. Immediately, this flight's becoming the focus of the whole world's attention. With 200 countries and thousands of newspapers reporting on the launch, well, this isn't the first time. So this leads to some. CEO Elon Musk says that SpaceX's first successful orbital Starship launch will, probably, occur between 1 and 12 months from now. Revealing a surprising amount about the near future of the next generation rocket program, in a short tweet. Join us as we bring you, Elon Musk just changed plan for Starship first orbital flight. The famously over-optimistic CEO's latest Starship schedule estimate is uncharacteristically cautious, hedged, and open-ended. While simultaneously setting some reasonable expectations about the likelihood of success. First publicly unveiled in September 2016, the fully reusable, next-generation rocket that eventually became today's stainless steel Starship, was tentatively scheduled to begin orbital flight testing in 2020. About 2 years after that first announcement, CEO Elon Musk unexpectedly sacrificed years of development work on Starship structures. When he decided to replace the rocket's carbon fiber composite airframe with stainless steel. Years later, it's still hard to say if that decision was the right one, but Starship development has been surprisingly unperturbed by such an immense last-second design change. While Musk was saying almost the same thing 12 months ago, the CEO now believes that Starship's first orbital launch attempt could happen as early as next month, September 2022. Simultaneously, Musk believes that the first orbital launch attempt could be successful, although it's not entirely clear how he defines success. Less optimistically, his August 2nd tweet also implies that he wouldn't be surprised if it takes SpaceX a year, in multiple attempts, to achieve Starship's first successful orbital launch. It's even possible to interpret his tweet as a warning that Starship's first orbital launch, while more likely to be successful, could be up to 12 months away. Somewhere in the middle 4 to 8 months from now, is a more reasonable bet for Starship's first successful orbital launch. As of early August, no aspect of recent Starship or Super Heavy booster testing is particularly encouraging, for a hypothetical September launch attempt. Super Heavy Booster 7 is still in the middle of repairs after surviving an accidental explosion. Yesterday, Elon Musk shares some glimpse of Super Heavy Booster 7 returning to the launch site for upcoming static fire. This time SpaceX tried to test outer ring 20 Raptor engine rather than 33 Raptor engine simultaneously. Booster 7 looks good for testing, maybe all repair has done and Booster 7 are on the launch site. Starship 24's latest round of testing, while not yet destructive, has been sluggish. However, in line with SpaceX's strict focus on maximizing the speed of Starship development, and shortening the path to orbit, the company has frequently built Starship hardware, before firmly assigning that hardware to any given ship, booster, or tank. In other words, until SpaceX actually begins stacking multiple completed rocket sections, there's always a degree of uncertainty about the fate of any given ring, dome, or tank barrel. First, let's look at the aspect of SpaceX. Clearly, this flight is considered to be a huge new development step for the company. The orbital flight is the first time that SpaceX has produced a full-size prototype, with two integrated parts together. Starship and Super Heavy will be nearly 120 meters tall. When stacked for launch, it's the largest monster on the planet ever built, simultaneously with this mission. Unlike the flight test, the altitude is only about 10 kilometers above sea level at current. Land Ship 24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 will make the longest flight ever. It will fly out of Earth's orbit, flying 3/4 of the way around the Earth. Because this is the longest flight, the flight time is the longest as well. This is a flight that's considered a new leap for SpaceX. Second, the Starship's first orbital test flight, though audacious in scale, will have the task of providing a rich source of data for further trips in the future. Mars, SpaceX intends to collect as much data as possible during flight to quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime, and that's extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally. This data will anchor any changes in vehicle design or conception of operations after the first flight and build better models for them to use in internal simulation. Third, this orbital flight will help SpaceX solidify its lead in the space race. Previously, people knew that SpaceX was famous for its Falcon 9, which is a partially reusable rocket that has saved a lot of money and time for the company with every launch. However, seeing some limitations that Falcon 9 could not bring to the company, they decided to build another line of rockets more powerful, larger scale, able to achieve the dream of bringing Elon Musk return to his planet Mars as everyone. Yokes, if Starship succeeds, SpaceX would further solidify its lead in the space race. Becoming the first company to be able to build a fully reusable rocket, capable of carrying the largest payload and can conquer all space surfaces like the Moon and Mars and beyond. At the same time, when its position's been proven, SpaceX easily becomes a reliable partner of other space companies and organizations. Following that, they'll be able to earn additional revenue from signed contracts. Only with SpaceX would certainly be flawed to talk about the meaning of this flight. Let's be honest. After SpaceX, NASA is definitely the one most looking forward to this flight. The agency has already made a bet on Starship, with a selection as the human landing system for Artemis, the largest cutting-edge vehicle now on the critical path to land humans on the Moon, NASA's most ambitious human spaceflight program in half a century. As a result, NASA's watching every step of the development of SpaceX Starship next. It can't be denied that this orbital flight has implications for the entire space industry and our planet. This flight will open the door to orbital tourist flights, which could render the aircraft industry obsolete. It's also one of the goals of SpaceX. But now, SpaceX beginning on August 3rd, abruptly flips a switch and starts to test Ship 24, with some degree of urgency. It's possible that the Starship could be cleared for the first orbital launch attempt by the end of August. Super Heavy is a much larger hurdle. Aside from the apparent removal of all of Booster 7's 33 Raptor engines, which will likely take 2 weeks to reinstall and recover, its status is somewhat ambiguous. If SpaceX decides to fast-track Booster 8, which is nearly ready for engine-less proof testing, the Super Heavy side of Starship's orbital launch debut is probably at least 2 or 3 months away from flight readiness. The Everyday Astronaut website maintains a calendar of events and expected milestones relating to Starship's FAA approval and initial orbital flight. It still lists July as a possibility for liftoff. A fuel explosion interrupted a static engine test of SpaceX's Starship Super Heavy lift vehicle. The accident could delay this summer's orbital test flight. Musk's claims about what will happen after that rocket is ready are even loftier. According to Musk, after SpaceX is done preparing a Starship and Super Heavy booster for their inaugural orbital launch attempt sometime next month. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.